Veronica. So since it's a small audience, I'd like to make it more informal and ask you to introduce yourself and say where you're from, what your role is, and what you hope to get out of the conversation.
I'm Veronica, I'm your host for today, but I work in IDP University in Atorrey, and I am the director of STEM proposal, the science, technology, and engineering for biotechnology students.
How are you? My name is Carlos Guevara. I am the director of the Office of Educational Technology and the Center for Teaching and Learning at Hostos Community College in New York, Kenny.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you for being here. So I serve as the Vice President for Information Technology Services at Cal State San Bernardino, and I've been there for 2 years. Before that, I was Vice President at a community college in Illinois called Carl Sandburg College in Galesburg, Illinois. So, how many of you have heard of San Bernardino? How recently?
Not recently,
okay. That's very good, actually. Okay. San Bernardino was in the news.
Oh, yeah. Well, you were in the poor San Bernardino was the shooting recently.
Yeah. It was, unfortunately, the wrong, kind of thing to be in the news for. But where the shooting happened, it was about 3 miles from the campus. So as the shooting was happening, there was a lot of commotion in the college, the university, and those police presence in the university, et cetera. The other thing about San Bernardino is we are right on the San Andreas Fault. Recently, anybody watched the movie San Andreas?
Yeah.
San Andreas Fault runs about a mile from the campus. So we are in the foothills of the San Andreas Mountain Range. So that's our claim to fame. So this is the state of California. How many of you have been to California? All right, perfect. Which part?
LA.
LA, okay. LA is Southern California. San Bernardino is about 60 miles. How about you? Where?
LA, San Clemente, San Francisco, San Diego.
So it's a large state, and we are in the southern part, and San Francisco and Sacramento are in the northern part. It's almost like 8 hours to travel from here to Sacramento. It's a very boring drive, so we try not to make that drive very often. Cal State San Bernardino has been around for 50 years. We're celebrating our 50th anniversary. So there are three higher education systems in California: the University of California system, the California State University system, and the community college system. The three state-funded university systems. And when the California has a, what if you can Google it, called the Master Plan for Higher Education, that was put in place by the previous governor. Governor Brown is the governor of California. His father was the governor in the 1960s, and he put together a very ambitious plan for California by establishing this three-tier system. And he said the University of California top students go to the University of California, the middle students go to California State University, and the rest of them go to community colleges. So 4.5, if you're in the 4.5% of your class, you go to CAD, you see, you know, and goes down. But the competition is so high. Today, if you are in the top 5%, you can't even get into a UC. That's how tough the competition has become. And so the bar has been raised for all admissions, and California State University system is basically running out of capacity. We have so many students, we have so little space. So these are the 23 outstanding campuses of the CSU, and here you see San Bernardino. You might have heard some of the Cal State systems: Cal Poly Pomona, Fullerton, Humboldt. So we're all over the place. So thank you. CSUSB, of course, we're one of the 23 campuses. We have 19,982 students. Our facilities were built for 12,000 students. And now we're actually exceeded 19,000. This year we went up to 20,000. 1,439 full-time and graduate faculty. We have 5 colleges, plus a college of extended learning, and we have a Palm Desert campus, which is about 70 miles from San Bernardino. So this is the organization that I lead. And when I came in 2 years ago, this is kind of the 5 goals that I gave to my organization. So, first of all, we need to provide world-class customer service. The customer service aspect of information technology services was so helter-skelter. People called the help desk the helpless desk. So that's how bad it was. We were open 24/7, but if you called after 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock with a problem, the guy who picked up the phone will say, just take a pill and call us in the morning. So, you know, faculty received almost no support. So we fostered support, faculty-led innovation and research. There was another organization called Office of Distributed Learning, which, let me ask you a question. Do you guys report to the provost office?
We don't even know.
Okay, who do you report to?
My supervisor, the dean.
Dean of the
university.
You know,
yeah.
Dean of this, okay, how about you?
And
library reports to the provost.
Library and our IT services. We report to the vice president of IT affairs.
Okay, the provost. How about you?
I can.
Okay. So there was an Office of Distributed Learning that reported to the provost office, and it was led by a faculty member, a tenured faculty member, became an administrator, and they had created all kinds of friction with the faculty because faculty believe that instructional designers don't know how to teach unless you're a faculty member turned into an instructional designer. You are a faculty, right?
Yeah.
You mean, so you have a lot more credibility. The instructional designers that we have are basically staff members. They're non-faculty.
We could rehire faculty, think of us in the library and you guys as technical support services.
That's the
we're not really faculty, we're technical support.
Yeah, that's exactly how it was. It's slowly changing, and I'll show you how we made that change happen. Improve operational efficiency, secure, stable, high performance infrastructure. You know, when I was hired, I heard horror story, and I still hear it till today. In 2013, spring semester, Blackboard was down for a whole week. doing markets a whole week. And people still say that, and they look at me, and I wasn't there. I was in Illinois, right? So systems were going down. Email would go down. When I was interviewing, the provost told me, you know, just get your email working. That's all I asked for. How hard is it? How bad of a request? End user empowerment, training end users to actually use the technology to do their jobs, right? So one of the things we started doing is we started telling the campus community, we come to play on your team. We're not a separate team with our own visions and goals. We want to be a part of your team. We want to do what you really want to do. We don't want to have our own agenda. Those we serve keep the score sheet. So I can stand here and say we do the greatest service, we provide world-class customer service. But if you poll a student at Cal State San Bernardino and they say IT sucks, you know, that's not, they keep the score sheet. The faculty keep the score sheet, the students do, and the staff do. If they tell us that we're doing a good job, then we are. And your win, their win, is our win. So that's the whole attitude change that we went through in IT services. Before IT services, you think we're our own domain, we take systems down when we want to, we protect your information, they didn't do any collaborative effort, but that's the change that we slowly are starting to bring. So we formed an IT governance executive committee. How many of you have IT governance in your institutions? So IT governance is made up of senior institutional leaders that provide oversight and accountability to all IT initiatives that happen on campus. So any IT initiative that is campus-wide always goes through IT governance. And the provost and I co-chair the IT governance executive committee. So the provost really leads the meeting. So when you talk about an academic institution, what is our core business? Technology is not, right? Technology is not our core business. It's teaching our students. It's supporting the faculty. That's our core business. So the provost leads